Welcome to the Sun Parlour Coffee House Sessions. I'm Jan Hall from Folk Roots Radio. The Red Dirt Skinners from Sussex in England have been taking the UK roots scene by storm. Winners at the British Blues Awards and a finalist at the Country Music Awards, their music has been rightly praised for its ability to cross genres. And there are special guests in the studio tonight. We have Sarah Skinner with soprano sax, Rob Skinner on guitar, and this is the title track of their last album, Behind the Wheel. Enjoy.
1, 2, 3, 4. I keep getting to these places that I like to call my own. I like to dream. Got a house in a small-minded street, in a small-minded town. It ain't nothing but a place to lay my head down. Just put me behind the wheel, way out on the road. Just put me behind the wheel. It's the only place I know that I can call my own. Maybe I'd throw a great big party and get the neighbors in. Never been someone with roots in just one town. I'd rather be on the road than stuck in the ground. Just put me behind the wheel, way out on the road. Just put me behind the wheel. It's the only place I know. So just put me behind the wheel, way out on the road. Just put me behind the wheel. It's the only place I know. So just put me behind the wheel, way out on the road. Just put me behind the wheel. It's the only place I know that I can call my own.
So Red Dirt music comes from the southern states, Oklahoma, Texas, and it's described as a combination of blues and country and folk and Americana and all the things that over the years we've been told that we are. So there's a little town in Oklahoma called Stillwater that we would really like to visit one day if the US will let us in. And this is a song about that town. It's just called Stillwater.
Stillwater. Water, so hard Take me down to the river end, where the water runs deep. Take me down to the river bed, for my heart is weak. Whoa.
That drinks in our local pub, and she's got a lot of history. She gives the impression that she's really lived, and she comes in every day for at least one glass of Chardonnay, and most days she's coming backwards and forwards between her house and the pub, and by closing time she's kissing everyone in the bar, and she loves us all. This song is called Thoughts of the Past.
Pretty sure she was beautiful. I'm pretty sure that she knows. Life's not been kind, but she said she don't mind. But I'm pretty sure that's the lie. Once was a girl with long golden hair. Now it hangs silver. Does it lie in her bottle of wine? And every day her Chardonnay is laced with ice and tears. And every glass she calls her last, but she's back for last orders again. I'm sure she had history. I'm sure you could say that she lived. But now every day, as her memory fades, she returns like a moth to a flame. And now just a song, her lover's all gone. She drinks at the bar to remember. Just a lone cigarette the past. And every day her Chardonnay is laced with ice and tears. And every glass she calls her last, but she's back for last orders again. I'm pretty sure she was beautiful. I'm pretty sure that she knows life's not been kind, but she said she don't mind. But I'm pretty sure that's a lie. I'm pretty sure that's a lie.
That's the Red Dirt Skinners live in the Sun Parlour Coffee House studio today with Thoughts of the Past from their latest album. It's entitled Behind the Wheel. And Rob Skinner and Sarah Skinner, it's great to be able to chat with you. I gotta say, I'm really excited to have you here. I'm a big fan of your music. I've had the opportunity to interview you before for my radio show. We now have you in the studio where we've been able to tape some wonderful videos of your songs to date.
Absolutely
fabulous.
Yeah, thank you for having us.
You're from Sussex in England. You're definitely the furthest that anyone has come.
I think so, yeah.
For a session. So tell us a little bit about your music. When did you get together?
Well, we've been working together since 2009. We met, Sarah was trying to put a blues band together, and she put an internet advert out for a bass player. And that's how we got in touch. And then about 6 months later, one of us had the courage to say, I like you, actually. Unfortunately, he set it back, so that's quite nice.
So if people haven't realised, you're actually a couple,
yeah,
as well
married,
as
yeah.
playing music together.
We are.
Yes.
When you play together, I didn't actually realise it was only, what, 6-7 years you've actually been playing together, because you give the impression that you have been playing forever together. Is that just the way it feels for you?
We spend a lot of time together.
Yeah, it feels like a lot of
time. Feels like it.
Well, the thing is, we're actually very lucky, because everyone says that, you know, you can't possibly work with your partner, and we actually don't really cross over a great deal when we're working together. You know, we have our own very specific jobs within the band, and the only time we're ever really working together is when we're writing. And in fact, that tends to be the only time we actually fall out. But Sarah is kind of the manager of the band, sort of operations manager, and she'll take care of liaising with you know, radio stations or gigs and that kind of thing. I'm a sort of tech guy, so I sort of make sure the equipment's working. I load the van, I always drive the van. I set up the gear, I pack it away, I do the sound checks, and Sarah doesn't get involved in that. So we don't really cross over a great deal. So there's never any kind of argument about what to do, because we have our own jobs. You know, we're kind of split in the middle like that.
So I think, Sarah, you actually come up with most of the ideas for the songs. Is that right?
I think so, yeah. I mean, I tend to come up with something in the middle of the night. I usually get up in the dark and write some sort of idea down. And I remember talking to you before about how my desk in my music room has orange pen all over it with the lyrics from one of our second album songs. So I'll come up with a vague idea, and Rob will come along and kind of tidy it up and embellish the chords and say, I don't like that lyric, or, you know, change this, that and the other, and make it a bit more interesting. So it's a good team in that respect too.
And I think it's fairly unusual that you play soprano sax with Rob playing guitar. It's not what people would expect at all, which is interesting. We mentioned at the start of the show today the fact that you have won a blues award for your music. Mm-hmm. You were also a finalist for a country music award. You really do cross the genres, but I don't think when anyone would have expected that, well, you know, soprano sax and guitar together and such a big sound. Is that because of your interest in the sound side of things, Rob?
I guess so, yeah. I mean, we've tried to make the sound as thick as possible, and when we added the extra percussion, I'm sitting there thinking, when I'm using both hands, I'm using my, you know, I'm singing it, I think, well, I've got two other limbs, I can probably do something with those. And in fact, what we used to use a full drum kit. So I used to have a kick drum and a snare drum, and I used to use the actual physical pedals to hit them. And it was just occasionally for some of the smaller shows, the snare drum on its side blasting straight into someone's face. It just was a little bit just too much. So we tried muting it, and then we realised that maybe the tambourine was a bit more appropriate. But we end up with this nice thick sound. Yeah, the tambourine adds a lot of top end. Obviously, the kick fills in the bottom end. And it feels like, it feels like another person. In fact, we've been accused of using backing tracks in the past as well. So, but yeah, it's a fairly full sound. You know, I tend to get quite a lot out of the guitar. I change the sounds for different songs, you know, sometimes. So I might have a lot more volume, a lot more mid for the picky ones, and then less for the strummy ones, you know. So, I think we're pretty pleased with the sound overall, for the live shows.
So tell us about your recorded music. Behind the Wheel is the latest album. Mm-hmm. Now, I gather there's a bit of a Canadian connection with that album. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Well, there's a song on there, Daybreak, which... We absolutely fell in love with Canada the first time we came here last June. And there's a song on there about our love of Canada, and particularly Constance Bay, and a good friend of ours that we met here, Doug, last time we came. And, you normally tell the story of this song,
yeah.
Don't you?
What happened with Doug? We ended up getting stuck. We were going to play a show in Constance Bay. And we ended up doing a show. And long story short, there was a misunderstanding. We didn't have a bed for the night. And at midnight, we found out that we were about 4 hours away from Constance Bay. And we had to phone Doug and say, is there any chance we can come and stay with you tonight? And I sort of explained that we were going to be getting there about 4 a.m. And he kind of went, oh, yeah, okay, no problem, like that. And he invited us up. And he made us feel so at home. Even at that time in the morning, he arrived with a beer in each hand like that. And just exactly what I needed to see at that time, you know. And, he's got a lot of land. And he was telling us about what to do if we encounter a bear. And he's telling me that, you know, you have to have your bear spray and you have to wait till it's like 2 feet away from you before you spray it. And I thought, no, I'm not going to be waiting anywhere. I'm going to be long gone. But there's references to that in the song. And the song ends with this big old sort of epic sounding, I suppose, sax solo and driving rhythms and the guitar going and everything. And that was the part that I wrote, wasn't it? That's from my kind of love of... prog rock kind of music and heavy metal and stuff like that. And that's how I got my little bit of influence onto the album.
Snuck in at the end of the album.
Yeah.
Well,
exactly.
We're going to finish with that song today. So okay. If you're watching this interview at home, stay tuned. You do not want to miss that song. But I think Behind the Wheel, the title track, also, I think part of the story behind that is traveling about across
it
Canada.
Is, yeah. I mean, Behind the Wheel is a travel song. It's just basically saying, we love being on the road. And the moment we get back, all we want to do is book up the next tour. So it's just, you know, I don't really have a place to be is one of the lyrics. You know, we don't really have a home and we just want to be on the road all the time and just exploring and meeting new people and finding new places to go.
So you're on tour in Canada while you're joining us today. Tell us a little bit about what you like about being over here.
Have you been to England?
I was born there.
Yeah, I know. Yeah,
it's not so bad. I think it's one of those things that, you know, you don't really know what you're missing until suddenly someone presents you with what you're missing, you know. And we got here and we just loved it straight away. We were here for 3 weeks on the first tour, and after the first week, we were thinking, God, this country is amazing. Everyone's so lovely. And after the second week, it was, I wonder if we could live here, you know. And after the third week, it was, well, that's settled then. That's what's happening. We're living here. We're going to try and move. In fact, if you don't mind me saying the story, when we took off from Pearson in Toronto, as the plane took off, we both looked at each other like that. And we both had these kind of glistening eyes like that, trying to shake it off. Yep. As if we weren't already decided. That's enough of a sign to us. You know, this is where we need to be.
Well, we feel very lucky to have you joining us today. If people want to learn more about your music, how can they do that?
You can find our website, which is reddirtskinners.com, or Facebook and Twitter. It's all just one word, Red Dirt Skinners.
Yeah. Well, I know people will definitely want to check that out. It's been an absolute pleasure.
Thank you,
to have you join us today. And we're going to finish with that song, because coming up right now, we have the Red Dirt Skinners live in the Sun Parlour Coffee House studio with Daybreak. And you've got to watch this.
First saw a firefly, where I first saw you smile, where the road's never ending,
out on Highway 9, found your house on the corner, up a long dusty drive. It was 4 in the morning, it was just getting light.
Said, why don't you head down the road to the Greystone Grill for a cup of coffee with me? Drove me around and you showed me the bay and I took a picture that I hung on the wall to remind me of you, and it makes me smile every day. And you taught me how to scare the bears away. And after the show we talked into the night till it was just getting light. Is the cabin ready? I don't want to wait another day. So Doug, are they all as good as you? What's it like in constant space? I could sit and listen to your stories till late in the night. So let's sit here and talk until it's just getting light. Thank you.
I was like, this is when the usual the bit. That's the red. No?
Oops.
No.
Okay,
here we go.
That's all, folks.